Listen to the wind. Listen to this. Okay, just left the city, which is all the way down there, and I'm headed to the jungle. Wish me luck.
Here, I just arrived.
Oh, it's a waterfall.
This is so refreshing when it's so hot.
come back down here.
Wow. Yeah, I love it.
Cold? Refreshing or cold? Which one?
It's pretty much just a group of people that came together. That's kind of cool.
They do. Oh, wow.
Hola, buenas. Hola. And look up, I was just asking for permission. If
oh, it's just come here.
Yes.
Oh, that's incredible. They built all this here. How many years ago was this?
This has been a work in progress in about 4 years.
4 years.
Mm-hmm. So they do yoga classes here, they do cacao ceremonies, sometimes some other plant medicine. They just sit around the fire and play music.
Plant medicine, though, like stuff like ayahuasca. Mm-hmm. They do that too?
Yeah.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah. I just got
Have you ever tried it?
Yes.
How was the experience like?
Pretty well. I prefer to do bufo.
What is that?
Bufo is the same thing. So most, are you familiar with the whole ayahuasca experiences? That in our system, all nature has DMT.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's from where you extract it. So ayahuasca comes from like the roots of these trees, versus the bufo, they extract the glands of this toad from the Sonora Valley in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
And they extract that, they crystallize it, they like do all this healing to it, and then you actually inhale the smoke. And it's the exact same experience without purging, although my experience is like purged without it, like you just, the whole system goes, but it's like this separation of body and spirit, and mm-hmm. it's pretty magical. It's really cool. And the people that have done it, you kind of have a connection,
except
you
them.
Just know, you just know. To all these people, you just know like who, you know who's who.
How long was
who's going to the other side?
Where did you do it? You did it here?
No, I did it with a shaman back at home with my mother, actually.
She really?
Invited me to check out these views.
Yeah, wow.
One of the tallest mountains, those two guys that were at the waterfall with us,
yeah.
Andres, he's another tour guide. Mm-hmm. He was with another guy and he was taking him up there. So they're gonna take about 2 days to get up there. You can do it in 1 day. It's about a 10-hour hike.
No more ride. No more motorcycle, I guess.
No. Well, you can get... I take a moto.
To go up here?
If you want to go, I just take a moto because it's a two-hour. And it's incredible. You wake up for sunrise and you get to see just the...
How long would the moto take you to get up there?
From right here, I think it's just another hour.
Oh, we should have done that then.
If you want to do it,
we could have
that's
done that.
Totally a doable thing from the other place.
Yeah, we could do this.
If you want to get all the way to the top,
what is this?
Totally doable. Yeah, so these are little huts, kind of like private rooms you can rent.
Yeah, it looks like there's somebody. I don't think someone's in there. No, there's no one in there. I thought. Para sentir que vivo intensamente, y para que tú sientas lo que eres para mí. Estoy enamorado de tu vida. Estoy enamorado de tu amor. Y cada vez que pienso en tu dulzura, comienza a florecer mi corazón. Me acuerdo que tú tienes tu luz propia, que siempre estás sonriendo para mí. Y empiezo a revivir en mi memoria. Incredible.
What's happening on the farm today?
Pineapples!
Putting compost out, putting beans on top, putting mulch on top.
Nice.
Just to cure all this. It's all dead.
Yeah. That soil gets so clayey and so sandy.
I need roots in it. I need ground cover.
Right.
So that's what I'm doing today. That's
nice.
The compost from the toilets, the shift compost.
Oh wow.
Cool.
You can smell that. There's no smell at all anymore.
Wow. Yeah, they do a dry compost toilet.
Yeah.
Have you seen one? I'll show you.
Yeah, I used to use one as a kid.
Right.
Your shit belongs to us.
That's you.
Yeah. Cool, I'm glad I contributed. Let me get to the baby leaves and then. I still love it though. I need more leafy greens.
I just eat so much mambe, I don't have to eat any leafy greens actually. My poop is green always. What is that, beans? Yeah, you cook them.
Oh, it's not.
Got it. Mixing it or are you just...
You have any mangoes here?
Yeah, but like small ones.
Small ones?
Like next to the house there's one that produces, the eating area.
That's
a small mango there. There's a small mango there.
So all this is work you guys put into this.
Mm-hmm.
Bringing the soil back, which is great.
Yes, I have my own place one day. I know exactly, I can immediately put 100 trees in, of all varieties. Because, of all the people I know, of all the projects that go on.
That would be good.
It's really cool.
Look over there. It's like...
I'm really grateful that there's minds like you guys
working
to protect
on doing this.
My country.
It's such a inchi.
What is that?
It's a nut.
Nut tree.
Oh. Get a journey to come up and get...
What tree is that? No, that big. That one here.
That one here?
Bamboo.
Yeah.
That, you mean...
Yeah, that.
That one.
Yeah.
Papaya, huh?
That's guarumo.
Guarumo.
Guarumo. And with the ash of these leaves, you mix it with the mambe, with the coca as an alkalizer.
Oh, is that what you use for your alkalizer?
Okay. Yeah. And I use, it's a great gripa cure. Or if you have a lot of tos, coughing, tea made of guarumo leaf, and it's gone within one day.
Really?
Wow. So do you make your own mixture of the
Does the leaves have... Does it have to be dry, or the leaves?
I take them fresh, but people say you can even use them dry.
You can use them dry.
I always
I see those trees all the time, but I have no idea what
they
are.
They get huge. The leaves get massive.
Down there,
there's
bigger ones. And the birds love them because they produce nice beans, kind of.
Yeah.
It's a grass. It's not really a tree. It's a grass.
Here's that peanut butter going to be ready.
There, yeah.
That is my one. But I actually have some to set over there.
Ooh. Where do you get your peanuts from? Here?
No, that's from El Sembrador.
I've been on the hunt for some, because I just like making my own peanut butter, and I just haven't gotten a good.
Yeah.
So in
mercado. You can get them down in Santa Marta, but I know a place in, it's called El Trompito.
El Trompito.
Yeah, that's before Palomino at some point.
Okay.
I've never been, but I know
You've
that
heard.
They're actually growing and producing now.
They're now my new best friends. I'm gonna volunteer to do photography for their retreat that they're doing. They're gonna be doing soon.
That's in
March 11th through the 17th.
Mm-hmm. I'd love to come back for that. So where are we right now?
So we have just gone up to Aloha Kea, which is a retreat center up in the Sierra Nevada of Santa Marta. And we came up on a motorcycle ride. It was really fun, very adventurous. On the way up, we stopped at a waterfall, took a cold plunge, and visited this really beautiful sort of reserve, permaculture farm, yoga center, music experiments, cacao ceremonies, vegetarian food galore, really awesome people. And now we are hiking over to another part of the mountain, and we'll show you what we got when we arrive.